wala dunyati ha
bici jitu moy 2015.
First, in 2015, I did not yet have the authorization to teach Imam Mahdi's mission. You can often see some Islamic scholars saying that Imam al-Mahdi himself does not know his real identity. He goes about his business. He can hear about Imam Mahdi, which prompts him to meditate and research it, until the day he finds out that it is in fact him, and many scholars support this theory. There are people who interpreted the video like that because for them, Sidi Muhammad al-Sheikh did not yet know his mission when he said that. I've heard people say that. To those, I tell them, no, the mission of Imam al-Mahdi has a given time and year, but also at age of 33, which he must reach before he is asked to start teaching his mission. I started teaching the mission of Imam al-Mahdi towards the end of 2017 and the beginning of 2018. During that period, what I wanted to teach there was not even about the fourth birth of Imam al-Mahdi, but I do not want him to be granted a nationality. See, the current problem in the Arab world regarding the Mahdi's mission is that someone is going to say that the Mahdi is going to be born in Africa. Someone else will refute this thesis and say that he will be born in Asia. And yet another will come and say that he will be born in Europe instead. We hear about it as far as France. Everyone wants to give him a nationality. So I tell them, if what is called a universal nationality existed, this is what we are going to give Imam al-Mahdi. Because his birth as a Senegalese doesn't really matter. What really does make sense here are his births during the four reincarnations. Indeed, if he was born Senegalese, French or Saudi, there would always be people who will dispute him. What brings about that dispute is that each of them wants to grant it to his people, to his country. I have taught that Imam Mahdi was born in Jerusalem. Indeed, his first birth is actually in Jerusalem. It is there that he will meet the Prophet Jesus. What is called a birth from the Ruhani side, namely from that is the first, will take place in Jerusalem. Namely from the soul and which can be referred to the mystic. One of the births that is the first which will take place in Jerusalem. So he can be considered as someone who was born in Jerusalem. A birth on the Ruhani side, which refers to the relationship he must forge with the Prophet Jesus, because it is there that they will meet. Then he will still be born on the Ruhani side in Mecca. There are those who say that he will be born in Mecca, which is true. There he will weave another relationship with the light that comes from the black stone, Hajar al-Aswad, which he will have to recover on Arafat's day. Then he will be born in Medina, as some people say, which is still true, where he will weave his relationship with the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. At the end, there are others who maintain that he will be born in the Islamic Maghreb. It is also true, precisely in Fez in Morocco, where he will weave his relationship with the light of the Qadmiyya and Katmiyya, who was no one but Mawlai Sheikh Mahdi Tijani, to finally appear in the Shahada world in West Africa, precisely in Senegal, to carry out the universal mission. Now, someone who hears these four mystical organizations, the one where he will have to be accompanied by the Prophet Jesus and which will take place in Jerusalem, the one where he will be accompanied by the light which is part of his mission and coming from the Hajar al-Aswad, which will take place in Mecca, the one where he must be accompanied by the light of the Prophet, peace be upon him, which will take place in Medina, the one where he must be accompanied by the light of the Qadmiyya to become the son of Mawlai Sheikh Mahdi Tijani on Ruhaniyu and Nuraniyu side and which will take place in Fez in Morocco. Finally, the one where he will appear in West Africa in Senegal. We have therefore reviewed the four stages of reincarnation. So, if someone stands up to say that the Mahdi is only Senegalese, that person does not know the whole reality behind the Mahdi's mysticism. Therefore, we can say that Imam al-Mahdi will be born in Jerusalem, in Mecca, that he will be born in Medina, in the Islamic Maghreb, in Fez, Morocco, to finally say that he will appear in West Africa in Senegal. There is a mystical organization behind each of these steps that accompanies the mission. So this is why we see the scholars never agree in their books. In some books, it will be written that Imam Mahdi is going to be born in Mecca, which is however true, but they cannot explain his birth in Mecca, because for the most part, they expect it to be a child who grows up and obtains a nationality. While next to it, there is another type of birth, which is the birth of the Ruhaniyu side, which does not mean that it happened in Alamul Arwah, Only the great mystics to whom Allah has conferred the science can unravel this mystery in the Shahada world, and Imam Mahdi is one of them. This is why we can say that he will be born in Jerusalem, in Mecca, in Medina, in Fez, and then to appear in Senegal. Now, what we can and cannot interpret about births remain in the appreciation of the listener. What we said in the video is what we thought again in the four reincarnations, and what we just said and explained again to make it clearer for everyone. So if Imam Mahdi was someone who was to be given a nationality, he would be given a universal nationality. Indeed, he had several births on the Ruhani side in various places which allowed him to forge mystical links with those who must accompany him before appearing in Senegal.